seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, ducking 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
For the wins, came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins. And the wheels are spinning, I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah, ayy. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. This was the scene a moment ago as the Bears emerge from their tunnel. Ready for football are they, and ready for football are we, as the Bears get set to match up with the Tennessee Titans.
Pat O'Donnell, the kickoff for Chicago.
The team, we're set for football, and off we go from Soldier Field.
Now this will make it into the end zone, and he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25.
Just 1 second showing on the play clock. We're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 12 yards there and a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll be brought down just shy of the 45.
Derrick Henry, the ball carrier.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
It's a gain of 5.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Second down, here's Henry. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's third down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, he breaks through.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 48, and he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. He's just got to be thinking, I hope that's not a harbinger of things to come. Very first pass of the afternoon picked.
And where do you go from here? Because when you start that way, do you allow that to seep into you and stay with you the rest of the game? Or do you find a way out of it? We're going to find out.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. First carry now for David Montgomery. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
Rashawn Evans.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you're scrambling a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Second down, Montgomery, and only able to get 2 here, stopped at the 30.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing, and I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid, part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. From the gun on third down, it's Trubisky. That is caught by Cohen. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing, but in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Eddie Pinheiro on now for the Bears. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. The kick by Pinheiro is good, and it's 3-0. The Bears hit the scoreboard first. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points, maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away. But they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
A second and 11 from the 19. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Complete. It's Henry. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll lead here to a third down.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for third down. Derrick Henry. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. And the Bears take over. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. They'll run for the first time with Tariq Cohen. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30.
The ball carrier.
Rashawn Evans out of Alabama had the tackle defensively.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And he'll complete this one to Patterson. No gain on that one, and it's going to bring up a third down. Well, he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch. And most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
On third down, Trubisky. Going up top for Miller. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line. By
the Titans. The good old cover three defense, partner. When you start playing football as a safety, that's the first thing you're taught. Middle of the field, be as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, and break on the football when it's thrown and pick it off, just as we saw there.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. After the interception, here's Tannehill. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback. But as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
Get up!
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. It's been an awfully slow start for them. This is their third possession. They don't have a first down yet.
So that means they have to change up what they're doing, and for some teams, it's a change in tempo, usually moving it to more up-tempo type of an offense just to try and change their fortunes right now. What they've been doing so far isn't working. Maybe they'll do that.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Now Trubisky going to give this to Montgomery. And he will finally be taken down at the Titans 33. It's a gain of 35.
Chicago Bears. First and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Three nothing after one on EA Sports.
Bears 3. Titans nothing.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now a shotgun handoff to Cohen. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
29, Tariq.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. From the gun, it's Trubisky. It's complete to Robinson. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 14. 16 yards, a first down.
First and 10.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game to play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason, so you can stay on the field and accumulate big plays.
This is a quick pass from Trubisky. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. A 14-yard touchdown. And the Bears will extend their lead. Eddie Pinheiro now for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0.
The score, Bears 10, Titans nothing. Pat O'Donnell to kick off for Chicago.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. A toss left, Henry. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Henry. And he's going to take this down close to a first down at about the Bears 42. 7 yards there and a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Tannehill. This will be caught by Brown. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
First down carry for Henry. Danny Trevathan there to bring him down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Second and five. Carry now for Derrick Henry, and he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Martinez Mingo on the tackle. A gain of four.
And they'll try to run for the first with Henry, and he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10.
I like his focus there, because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need one. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up two.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. On first down, Tannehill. On the screen, this is Evans. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 7 yards there on the first down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Second down, ball on the 3. First down marker at the 1 yard line. They'll run with Henry. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2 yard line. But we know he's an electric runner. Earlier this half, you were wondering how they were going to bottle him up at different levels. That was your suggestion. Some mixed results.
Yeah, certainly, because we have seen him bottled up at times. We've seen him play him very well. We've also seen him pop the cork a few times and get out of there, haven't we?
We have indeed. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Heavy set out there on third and one. Now it's Henry. Yeah, Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. He needed two. He got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
To get the offense off the field, they'll stay put on fourth and one. Tannehill keeps on the sneak, and he'll be taken down after a short gain as that takes us to the 2 minute warning. They try the sneak, but not enough push. He doesn't get in, and the Chicago defense able to come up with a goal line stand. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And that last touchdown drive they had, very balanced. How key is that balance?
It's huge because most of the time when we talk about balance is run, pass, almost 50-50. But most of the times when you talk to offensive coaches, they say balance is we do what we want when we want to. And that means that they're ahead of the defense, keeping them on their heels.
Yeah, they impose their will on that last drive. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. On 2nd and a couple, Trubisky. And he rifles one incomplete. Cole Kmet, the intended receiver. And it's 3rd and short.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. They'll run it. Here's Montgomery. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Now Tennessee going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Pat O'Donnell now as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Here comes Humphreys on the return. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And it'll be Titan football.
At their own 41-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time, they had it 4th and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. It's Khalil Mack that time, shooting in there to get him to the ground.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
The job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's 2nd and 20. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Now the Bears will use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So 3rd and long after the sack. Tough task for Tannehill and the Titans. From the gun, here's Tannehill. And he's got a man, Corey Davis. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A real letdown defensively. That was 3rd and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Now the Titans will use their 3rd and final timeout. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Tannehill. Under pressure, and he's going to go down. Tannehill sacked. Robert Quinn just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. The final shot here before the break, Tannehill. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Set to resume. Here we go with the 2nd half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback.
Put that thing up where you're burning. six figures every year. Yeah.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Second and four. Out of the gun, running with Cohen. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. He got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more.
But that's all about doing the dirty work right there defensively. Second and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving the running back a crease to run through. And has a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a third down.
Snap it at one. Now it's Trubisky. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, it certainly looked to me like he tapped into the quarterback's thought process there. And what I'm hearing more and more when I go around the league, defenders sitting in on quarterback meetings trying to learn more about how they think so they can be in the right position to be in the right spot, as he was there to pick that one off and take it all the way back for a touchdown.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
It's now second and 10.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
Second and 10. From the shotgun is Trubisky. He'll leave it for Cohen, complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
They face a third and four after that last completion gets them six. Patterson on the carry. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Humphreys now to return. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And that will come the offense as they take over.
At their own 17-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors. But overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They keep it with Henry on first down. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
Gibson brought him down.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Henry will get it. He's been busy today. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
But when you go from second and four to third and three, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, second round the defense. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And he will be knocked down hard, but he will have the first down. 6 yards there. First down, Tennessee.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? Lava's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. They'll try the air now with Tannehill. Looking here for Smith downfield. And this one is incomplete. Jonnu Smith, the tight end, his intended receiver. And it's second down.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
Glad you're with us from Soldier Field in Chicago. Third quarter here, second and 10. Tannehill now to throw. And this one complete to Smith. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. Back to the ground now. It's Henry. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs. That big guy, oh, he's a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10, right at the 40. This is Henry. And a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the 33. Ball carrier.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. Now it's Tannehill. That's complete to Darrington Evans, the running back. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
First down, Henry. Give him 16 yards there, a Tennessee first down.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Now a first down throw, Tannehill. Buying time to his left. And now he lost the football. Tannehill loses it. And this is picked up by the Bears. He's at the 50. He's at the 40. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's the run with Montgomery. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Rashawn Evans on the tackle. A seven-yard pickup brings up second and three.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Titans 7.
Second down with Cohen. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
Rashawn. Definitely too early to panic, but that is his fourth carry of the game. And collectively, hasn't totaled 10 yards. So maybe there's no panic, but maybe some concern.
Yeah, and maybe a little concern up front because they're not giving him any space right now.
The Bears on third down, a pretty woeful 0 for 5 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one.
He's checking, he's checking, he's checking.
Now Trubisky going to give this to Montgomery. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22.
Good.
3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now they'll throw it with Trubisky. And he whips that one incomplete there. Trying to get it to Tariq Cohen out of the backfield. That'll bring up second down.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Now Trubisky to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. DaQuan Jones. Able to drop him for a loss of four from his defensive tackle spot. After that sack we just saw, Trubisky and the Bears deal with a third and long. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Bears on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third and 14. Here's Trubisky to throw. And he completes it to Cohen. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down.
They got the completion, but they didn't get the first down. So you got to think, if you're on the defensive side of the ball, you're pretty happy with what you just accomplished there.
Yeah, guy, like you said, got him out of bounds, stopped the clock, kept him short of the marker.
Matt Nagy has made the decision. They're going to go for it here.
Alert, alert, alert. He's coming, he's coming.
this one to tight end. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. Able to convert on fourth to bring up first and goal. That's a big 3 yards right there. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Leads to second and goal at the 10-yard line.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. They try again with Cohen. And a nice pick up there. It gets about five down to the 4-yard line. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal.
He's coming. Double up, double up.
A give to Montgomery out of the gun. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on, and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here, a major letdown. This is the time to go and put six on the board.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. This is up and good from Pinheiro. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. So they get the three, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now. They feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction. All of a sudden, they're down.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And that last turnover could have proven more costly, but their defense only gave up three. But now answering with a field goal doesn't do them much on this drive. They need to try and find the end zone. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
At the 23-yard line.
That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Back to throw, Tannehill. Got a man, it's Brown. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Running from the gun with Henry, and he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. A pickup of 5 yards, first down Tennessee.
5 yard gain on the play.
For Tannehill on first down. He'll look downfield for Humphreys. Oh, wide open, complete. And he will be taken down, but it is a huge play there to flip field position. And they'll be on the other side of the field as we have reached the 2-minute warning.
Let
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. A first down carry for Henry. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. A good response by the defense, sending them backwards after that huge gain last play. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. He's back to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee.
Derrick Henry.
Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Titans can have the lead if they hit the extra point. Now they can boot it through on the always important extra point, and then their defense has to hold up their end of the bargain.
And there's something that you've pointed out in numerous games that we've worked. Okay, the excitement's going on. Everyone's celebrating over there. Who's calling up the defense to make sure they're focused, because they still have some work to do?
And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
21-yard line.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Trubisky. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
They head to the line facing a third and 7 following the incompletion on second down. And that's knocked away and incomplete. This defense so strong all afternoon long, well executed again there.
This is a group that really functions well off of each other. No matter what the assignment, the other person fills in the exact proper spot. They've made it very, very hard for them to find open places to throw the football.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And they will finally put an end to the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line.
Goal to go at the 8-yard line.
It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. Try and run for it with Henry. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
So this one, a Tennessee Titan victory, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days,
over grind, game over, time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Take your L like a boss, dancing toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't